Now, what I can say about the senior high schools, free senior high school system is this. I was amazed the number of young people who now want to be in secondary school. I had no idea that we're going to have an extra 70, 80,000 young people who want to be in school. That for me, it blew my mind. And it also gave me the hope that we have to raise our young people to the highest standards. Now, let's go back to how the system works. I'm familiar with I taught in the US and a system like that. We call it the year-round school. So instead of three vacations, we have two vacations and we run what we call a semester system. So we have the spring semester and you have the fall semester. But then you want to look at your condition before you make a decision like that. The condition being this, the numbers that you have, can the existing system support you? If the existing system doesn't support, then what do? You have to kick in plan B. That's one way to look at it. Another way to look at it is this. These days, why do we have to spend so much time in school when we can begin to use technology? This is something that it has to kick in. I'm not saying that we are prepared for that, but we have to make our minds for that. And also we want to begin to look at the large expanse of time where young people now have more time to themselves in the long vacation. There are two of them. This is where I think the private schools have to come in and begin to offer courses that are not mainstream in the Ghana Education Service syllabus. And this is what I mean. We have to now begin to look at how we're going to use computers for web designs. That's an area that we have to begin to looking at digital technology. So what we have to do is begin to identify the needs. So website, we want to begin to look at how we can develop software packages that will make people's life easier. Young people are interested in those kinds of things. We have to begin to look at digital technology, even in terms of imaging of the human brain. They are all, we have what we call an ecosystem in education.